Felicitous greetings, fellow fanatics.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm Adam the Fanatic, and today we're going to be taking a look at Chimera, Destroy All Monster Girls, a free retro-inspired platformer by Suits and Sandals. Why is it spelled with a K? Is she going to cameo in the next Mortal Kombat or something?
Chimera is a retro-inspired platformer where you'll confront stages in variable order. Said stages are mostly linear, but have numerous secrets hidden throughout them, including a number of health upgrades. At the end of each stage is a boss fight, and upon completing a stage, you'll gain a permanent ability from the boss you've just defeated. Once you've defeated all standard bosses, you'll gain access to a gauntlet of a few final levels, including one that ends in a boss rush against all the stage bosses you defeated earlier in the game, just before heading to the final battle. And in said final battle, the boss will have multiple forms.
Sound familiar yet? Now, let me be clear, I have nothing against games that take heavy inspiration from other titles. The question is it a good Mega Man clone, or is it just a cheap knockoff? That is what we're here to find out.
Chimera starts off with a band of pirates attacking a hapless yet wealthy island in the Mediterranean. A lone mad scientist has retired to the island, but sadly has no death rays ready to fight them off. This is definitely a case of you had just one job to do and couldn't even do it right. Luckily, what he does have is a prototype biological chimera that he's Frankensteined out of spare parts. So you take on the role of Chelsea, whose purpose is to chase down the pirates and reclaim the island's stolen treasure. Narratively, you're not getting much more story than that. There's still a fair bit of dialogue in the game, but it's played for laughs and comes off with a very Saturday morning cartoon style. At its heart, Chimera is a pretty straightforward platformer. You'll run and jump, and you can punch with Chelsea's giant stone fist to combat enemies. In addition to your standard punch, you'll also have access to a dash punch. When you attack like this, you'll shoot straight for a short distance, and this can be used not only to attack, but also to get some extra distance with your jumps. Speaking of jumps, she's also capable of double jumping. Between your double jump and dash attack, you'll find that you have quite a bit of freedom of movement in this game, which you'll often need to use to find those secret alcoves. When you find said secrets, they may include extra money and health, caged fairies to free, notebook pages with info on the game's characters, permanent health upgrades, or even unlock hidden levels. After you clear the intro stage, you'll be thrown onto a Super Mario Bros. 3 style world map, where you can visit town, the professor's lab, or challenge the main four stages in any order that you like. Once you've defeated these four levels, you'll unlock the Black Widow, a gauntlet of three stages on the pirate ship where you must confront the pirate captain in her own lair. As you complete stages, you'll get new abilities in Mega Man-like fashion. Defeat any of the four main stages, you'll gain an ability from its boss. Unlike Mega Man, you have no limit to how often you can use these. These include an uppercut that launches you high into the air, great for speedrunning or just avoiding small segments of platforming, the ability to form a treasure chest around you to smash enemies below, and a charge shot that honestly might be a little too good. Seriously, I'm getting Metal Blade flashbacks from this. Once you get it, there's no reason to use anything else against bosses for the rest of the game. Just spam your charge shots and watch them cower in fear. On the presentation side of things, the game's art is okay. I'm not saying it's bad, but graphically it's not great either. I love well-done sprite work, but even compared to something with lower pixel density like Shovel Knight, Chimera feels a little flat. On the other hand, its sound design is on point, perfectly capturing that 8-bit chiptune feel. These songs definitely feel like something I could hear on the NES in general, or in a Mega Man game in particular. And there's a fair bit of side content as well. Unlockable costumes, a berserker mode where you both deal and take extra damage, and even a dedicated speedrun mode which removes all dialogue from the game and gets you straight into the action. And you know, in case there was any lingering doubt in your mind that this was inspired by Mega Man, this is what the stage select looks like for the speedrun mode. So how does this compare to a certain other Mega Man inspired retro throwback platformer? Well, Chimera is definitely the easier game of the two, and it's certainly a shorter adventure than Shovel Knight, even if we only count Shovel of Hope and ignore everything else that Treasure Trove has to offer. As aforementioned, I definitely prefer Shovel Knight on the graphical side of things. When it comes to level design and fun boss fights, these games are honestly pretty equal. And while Treasure Trove far, far outpaces Chimera in terms of game length, you have to remember, Chimera is a free game, whereas Shovel Knight isn't. It's a little unfair to compare the two in terms of production values when Chimera doesn't cost a cent to play. There is a single DLC costume that will set you back $1 if you choose to purchase it, but that's really just a tip jar to give the devs something for their hard work. If I could only play one, yes, I would ultimately choose Shovel Knight. But if you're a fan of Shovel Knight, you'll probably enjoy Chimera as well. And seeing as it is a free game, you really can't go wrong. But Chelsea's adventures do not end there. A spin-off called Chimera Puzzle Island will be out soon, with a planned release date of November 30th. In Puzzle Island, you'll be solving nonagrams, also known as Picross if you're a Nintendo fan. I've never been one to shy away from pencil puzzles, so I'll probably be taking a look at it eventually. The jump from platformer to nonagrams is a little odd, but it worked for Mario, so why not? In conclusion, there's a lot to enjoy about Chimera. It's a fun little platformer, and there's quite a bit of content despite the adventure's brevity. Playing through it definitely has me wanting to go back and dig out my classic Mega Man games, not because it's a poor ripoff of them, but rather because it's a solid homage. Upgrades are fun, even if some are less useful than others, and while the game is a little on the easy side, it's still a blast to play through. On the downside, the artwork is a bit lacking. As I mentioned before, the game is pretty short. I did a 100% run to replay for this, and it still only took me a little over 2 hours. It'll probably take you a little longer on your first playthrough, but it's still a pretty short game. Despite this, Chimera is a solid title that I find to be worthy of a 7.8 out of 10. If you're interested in downloading Chimera or learning more, links are included in the description. But what about you? What do you think of Chimera? What other free games would you recommend? If you have any questions, remarks, or opposing points of view, leave them in the comments down below. Please remember to like, share, subscribe, and ring that bell. Until next time, farewell, fellow fanatics. Thank you again for watching. I have plenty more to share with you if you're interested. You can click up here above my head to subscribe to my channel. You can click over here on my monitor to see the most recent video that I've worked on. Or if you prefer, you can click up here to open this mysterious vault and see what video that the YouTube algorithm has picked just for you.